Hi, my name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer and writer, and I pride myself on always being inspired. I'm not saying that it's true, that I am always inspired, but what I strive for is to never be without inspiration. That doesn't mean that I always act on that inspiration. That doesn't mean that it always leads me to a fulfilling piece of art or a place that I feel really comfortable in, but I am always thinking about how to consistently stay inspired in my life and in my art, which also means my career. I want to share 5 ways to stay inspired, but really what I mean is I'm going to give you a whole bunch of ways to stay inspired, and I hope that you pick and choose what works best for you. The art that I've created has been photography, filmmaking, and writing. So that's where I'm coming from creatively, but any of these tips will work for just about any type of art that I can think of. The first thing that keeps me inspired is working with no budget. Going around your house, finding any everyday objects that you can that could contribute to either inspiring your art or be used directly in your art. Let's go see what we can find and create. I'm going to make something now out of what I can find around my house. Always look for free props. Hey, I'm talking to you. Bed sheet. Should work very nicely as a costume. In my house, it's really easy to find good props that are just laying around. Books are a consistently good prop. I just went around my house and I looked at a few random things that I could use in a photograph. And I challenge you to do the same, just to go looking at things a little bit differently. So maybe you pick up a lamp and you decide you're gonna use a lamp for your craft. If it's an image, maybe you use it to light yourself. If you're not a photographer, maybe you think about what a lamp represents, which is light in a dark space. So maybe you end up using a lamp metaphorically in that way instead of physically. But either way, how can you use something around you in your everyday life to inspire you to create something new in your craft? So I'm going to create now what I'm using, which is a bed sheet and this weird skull that I have, and just my hands. And I'm going to create this sort of eerie death landscape picture where I'm going to be the only thing in pure white in the image, and hopefully it'll be really fun and impactful, and if not, it'll definitely at least be fun. If you haven't seen my White Wall Wednesday video series, I highly recommend that you check that out, because it's basically what we're doing here, which is finding inspiration when maybe there's nothing actually that inspiring around you. So it's just a bunch of how do you create in a blank space against a white wall with what you have, and that's what we're about to do. So I'm just getting ready to change into my costume, which is actually just a bed sheet. I'm not even using like a clip or anything. I'm just holding it and I'm just gonna let this arm dangle and hope that it looks okay. I finished the main part of the shoot, and now I'm actually going to photograph just my hands, because what's better than a totally free prop, right? So I'm gonna photograph my hands. So that's what I'm going to do about 20 more times. Tip number two is daydreaming. It's really weird, I know. I've talked about this in videos before, but it has to be mentioned. What I do every single day, whether it's for 1 minute or 5 minutes, is I close my eyes and I simply allow myself to daydream, in which I am the main character of the daydream, and I sort of watch myself and narrate myself going through adventures or just sitting in a calm place or walking through a forest. It can be something super simple, but allowing yourself to daydream, to really think of a dream, like a dreamlike scenario or a place that you really want to be or experience, and then have yourself go through those motions like you're a character that you're dreaming up, that is the most valuable tool to me in terms of staying inspired on a regular basis. You have to exercise your imagination just like any other muscle. You have to allow your imagination to go free. You have to allow it to stretch and expand and discover things that you didn't even know were hidden inside you. Number three is metaphor dice, which is a really, really weird one. So let me show you. I just came across this via a Kickstarter, and this is a product by the poet Taylor Molly, who is incredible, and I love following his work. And he put out this product called Metaphor Dice. And Metaphor Dice is basically a series of words, or a couple of words, that you put together in random order, and it's sort of like a writing prompt, but I actually use it for a few different things, not just writing, but also my photography and filmmaking, to come up with a quick idea, something poetic, something beautiful that can trigger visuals for me. I've got the metaphor dice here, and the way that this works is that you arrange them with the different colors all put together, and you just shuffle them. So you see what you come up with. You roll them and then see what words come up, and then you put together a little metaphor. So this one that I rolled says power divided songbird. And the way that you would make a metaphor is to say power is a divided songbird or something like that. And so we roll them. So let's see what we get from the set. Okay. Oh, it's so good. So this one says passion is an unofficial promise. Ah! I didn't even make that up. That's just, that really happened. Let's roll again and see what we get. Oh, this is good. This one says love, desperate drum. So we could make up the metaphor, love is as desperate as a beating drum. Or something else like, love is only desperate when the drum stops beating, or something like that. And then, like, some of them are really fun. Like this one says, my birth is as rugged as a superhero. What? So like, they're really interesting. Death is not a cryptic wasteland. Let's do that one. Okay, so here's your challenge this week, is to create something out of either this metaphor or another one that you randomly put together in any way that you want. I'm going to create an image based on death is not a cryptic wasteland. Yeah. Number four is having a mission statement. Having a statement that goes along with the art that you create that you can constantly go back to ground yourself. If you think about any successful company, they'll have a mission statement, whether it's directly on their website or just behind the scenes. It's really common. I remember even when I had jobs as a teenager, like in a nursing home, for example, or at a theme park, there was always a mission statement that they gave us, like in the info packet when I started a job. And those mission statements let me know very concisely exactly what that company was striving to do. I believe that we as artists should also have a mission statement, that we should have a single line that tells ourselves and people who are looking at our work what we are all about. if we have a mission statement, whether that's just a theme that we consistently follow through our art or something else, whether it's a mission that we want to make people feel a certain way, that's going to allow us to constantly go back to a single idea instead of constantly grasping for tons and tons of unlimited ideas. The idea is simple. We have a certain statement that we go back to, and therefore if our brains are reeling or we're just blank inside, we always have that anchor point to go back to and create from. Tip number 5 is to come up with a daily writing prompt. Now there are about 5,463, that's not true. There are more than that. There are tons and tons and tons of writing prompt websites online. So if you just type in writing prompt or daily writing prompt, you're going to find that there are tons and tons of writing prompts out there. Why writing? And you might be thinking, well, it's because I'm a writer. It's not. I believe that writing is one of the best ways to free our mind. We are so constantly thinking about so many things, what we have to do, who we have to take care of, what our responsibilities are, that we can't let go of that very easily. If we can, for just a few minutes a day, free write, like stream of consciousness writing, that allows us to shove all of those things out of the way, the things that are not serving our creative mind, and allow ourselves to sink into our greatest creativity. If you don't want to do a daily writing prompt, I recommend just a few minutes of stream of consciousness writing, which is where you're going to put your pen down on paper and you're not going to stop writing for a certain amount of time. Even if you have to write scribbles or you just have to write your name over and over, that's okay. But spend just a few minutes just writing and writing and writing and see what comes of it. And you might find a few minutes of writing to be extremely daunting at first, but the more you do it, the easier it becomes until you find you can just flow with your writing for a very long time. Every time I do this exercise, my brain feels so clear. Like I can find ideas, pull them out of a hat like a magic bunny, and that is what I want for all of us. Here are some bonus ways that I stay inspired, and they might be a little bit weird and not so direct, but bear with me. One of them is writing to-do lists. It's very weird for staying inspired because it doesn't seem inspiring at all. The fact is that the more level-headed and clear I feel about what I need to do in a day, the more I can really settle into my creative time when there is time allotted for it. So I'm not thinking about, oh, did I forget something? Do I have to do something? I'm not thinking about it at all because I already did it or I know it's on my to-do list. So having a to-do list is, for me, the only way to stay inspired. If I feel frantic in my mind, if I feel disorganized, it is terrible. Which brings me to another way that I stay inspired, which is to keep my workspace really clean. And I know that that's an odd one too, but it's true. If I see clutter around me, then I feel like I cannot be creative. It's the same sort of thing for me. Like if I feel sad, I feel really consumed by those emotions and I don't feel like I can really put all of my thoughts process into creating. Another way to stay inspired is to remind yourself of the impact that you have or can have. You might be thinking, I don't have any impact or I haven't done anything that would impact somebody in any meaningful way yet. And that's the word that you have to add to the end of that sentence, yet. What is possible is ahead of you. So if you can focus on what will my impact be? How can I impact people? How do I want to impact people? What do I want my art to say to other people? Then you can create from that space of thinking not only of yourself, but of others. And I'm not saying to create solely for others. Don't create just what other people want to see, but how can you create something that fulfills yourself that also unlocks something for somebody else? Maybe they need to hear it, or maybe it's just a little gift that they can take home that day. Another way to stay inspired is to join a meetup group, to go online and see if you can find like-minded people, to join a challenge group, to join some sort of group where you feel like you can lean on other people, go over ideas with other people, get critiques from other people, and be held accountable. It is so important that we're held accountable to our art because art is like anything else. Just like the imagination muscle, we have to keep practicing it so that it becomes part of our daily routine. Here is a fact. If people stop practicing their craft, they're not going to grow in their craft. I believe that our craft gets better the more we practice it, just like anything. So if we want to create consistently good art, we need to make art. consistently. If we want to stay inspired, we have to practice being inspired consistently. And finally, a big one for me is cleaning your newsfeed. I mean, how often are we distracted by what we see online? Either because we feel intimidated or daunted by what we're seeing, it's so good or it's so great, or I wish that I could be that person. And all of that happens, and it happens naturally, and it's good to follow people that inspire you, but make sure that you're looking at these things intentionally. There are artists that I love that I know if I look at them too often, I start to feel like I doubt myself, I'm not really sure about what I'm doing anymore, so I intentionally only go to their sites when I want to see what they're doing, instead of on a constant bombardment basis. This has been 5+ tips of staying inspired, and I know that you have some of your own, so please let me know what your tips and tricks are to stay inspired. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you will subscribe and share this video with anyone that you think needs to be inspired, because let's face it, it is something that a lot of people are sorely lacking in our lives today, and I really want everyone in the world to be inspired, because the more inspired we are, the more art we create, and the more art we create, the more we can impact the world in a positive way.